Hi, dear students. So today, let's talk about DNA sequencing. So what is DNA sequencing? DNA sequencing is a process of determining or identifying the order of nucleotides present in a DNA sequence. For understanding the structure and function of a gene, it is very important to study the nucleotide sequences of it. DNA sequencing serves this purpose. In a sequential manner, the long chain of DNA is read by the sequencer machine. DNA consists of the nitrogen bases adenine, thymine, cytosine, and guanine. And the other ingredients are sugar and phosphates. DNA sequencing is termed as a laboratory technique employed to know the correct DNA sequence by the sequential chemical reaction. Laboratory processing and computational analysis are the key process in DNA sequencing. In the process, the amplification done by each nucleotide is recorded in the form of signals, which are cut by the machine and analyzed on the computer. The nucleotides are either radio or fluorescent labeled. The story of DNA begins when Watson and Crick discovered the structure of DNA in the year 1953. Thereafter, in the year 1977, Frederick Sancher postulated the first method for sequencing the DNA and named as a chain termination method. In the same year, the chemical method of DNA sequencing was explained by Alan Maxim and Walter Gilbert. So, what are the steps in DNA sequencing? The first step is sample preparation, that is DNA extraction. Here the DNA is our starting material, therefore we need to isolate DNA first. It can be from animal, plant, bacterial, or any environmental DNA can be used for it. The next step is PCR amplification of target sequence. Amplification is an important step in sequencing. Here only the gene of interest or the DNA sequence we wish to study is first amplified and the rest of the DNA is discarded. The next step is amplicon purification. Amplicon is a pure DNA fragment. It's always necessary to make the process devoid of contaminations. If any unbound primers or unused tag DNA polymerase or unused DNA templates or unused PCR reaction buffer components are present, these can lead to abort DNA sequencing. That is the reason why amplicon purification is required. And the next step is sequencing pre-preparation. Sample pre-preparation is a very crucial step during DNA sequencing. During this step, adapted DNA sequences are ligated on both DNA ends. To the adapter, the primer anneals for doing amplification. And this amplification process in sequencing is similar to PCR. But the nucleotides here are either radio or fluorescent labeled. Next step is the DNA sequencing. The prepared reaction tubes are placed in the sequencer machine. During the reaction of the sequencer, denaturation, annealing and extension occur simultaneously. Here we are using labeled nucleotides. The signals produced during the reaction is recorded. And the data is sent to the computer for data analysis. Once the whole DNA is sequenced, sequence data is compared with other available data by the software to find out variation and other mutation present in a gene. This flowchart represents the general steps in DNA sequencing. The steps mentioned here vary from platform to platform. It's just a generalized representation. As I told, The main step is sample preparation, PCR amplification, amplicon purification, sequence pre-preparation, DNA sequencing, and finally data analysis. So now just we will look into the methods in DNA sequencing. There are different methods of DNA sequencing: maximum and Dilbert method, chain termination method by Sancho, semi-automated method, automated method, pyrosequencing, the whole genome shotgun sequencing method, clone by the clone sequencing method, next generation sequencing, NGS sequencing method. So just we will check into one by one. So the first one is Maxim Gilbert sequencing method. The Maxim and Gilbert method was developed in 1977. It is also referred to as a chemical cleavage method. DNA extraction is the very first step. After that, the DNA is denatured using the heat denaturation method and single-stranded DNA is generated. The phosphate end of the DNA is removed and labeled by the radio label phosphor. The enzyme named phosphatase removes the phosphate from the DNA, and simultaneously the kinase add the phosphate to the 5' end of it. Four different chemicals are used to cleave DNA at four different positions. Hydrazine, hydrazine NaCl are selectively attacked, pyrimidine nucleotides, while dimethyl sulfate and piperidine attack purine nucleotides. After the labeling, an equal volume of four different single-stranded DNA samples taken into four different tubes, each containing four different chemicals. The samples are incubated for some time and electrophoresed in polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis. The result of the chemicals cleavage of four different tubes are shown in this figure. Due to the radiolabeled phosphor end of the DNA bands visualized through autoradiography. Let's see an animated version of the Maxim-Gilbert method. It's based on the sequencing of nucleotides by cleavage at specific site, and these sites include cleavage at guanine, guanine and arginine, cytosine, cytosine and thymine. The first step of this method involves the radiolabeling of the DNA to be sequenced. The 5' end of the DNA is removed by alkaline phosphatase. Simultaneously, the kinase adds P32 to the 5' end of it. And this allows the sequence will be obtained from the 5' end of the DNA. The next step involves the cleavage of DNA at specific bases. For this purpose, the polynucleotide chain is divided into four tubes. Each tube will have reagents that will cleave the polynucleotide chain at the specific site. These include G, GNA, C, CNT. talk about the cleavage of sheep. The guanine is methylated by dimethyl sulfate, and the methylated cheese guanine is treated with 4-piperidine. Then the sugar phosphate backbone gets cleaved. Now, cleavage at sea. Here, hydrazine in presence of 1.5 molar NaCl along with 4-piperidine. It goes cleavage at sea. Now, cleavage at sea and T. Hydrazine without NaCl in the presence of 4-piperidine. We bring cleavage at and cleavage at G and A. It's treated with formic acid and 4-piperidine. Once the DNA is cleaved with specific residues, the fragments are separated by using high resolution polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis. The gel separates all the fragments present in the reaction mixture. However, we are only interested in the fragments having radioligable P32. The gel is exposed to X-ray film for autoradiography. This will detect only radioactive fragments having P32. Electrophoresis is carried out each tube side by side. Now, as the smallest fragment are present at the bottom of the gel, we read the gel from bottom. Lane 2 and 3 represents C plus D. Lane 2 and 3 have two bands. So, the first nucleotide is C. Next, the second plane consists of a single band in C plus D. So, but there is no band representing C in link 2. So, the second nucleotide will be P. Link 4 has a In this way, we can find out all the nucleotides that is present. So, the Maxim-Gilbert method is more accurate than Sanger sequencing. It's best suitable for DNA bookbinding and DNA structural studies. In this present automation time, this method is used in genetic engineering studies. But the scalability of it is poor and only 400 base pairs can be sequenced. Moreover, it is less popular because of the use of harmful radio-labeled chemicals.